Hello, everybody. Cynical Pundit here. I'm back again, and we are doing a very special episode of Salt. For those of you that don't know, back in May of 2017, I did a video called Samurai Salt 99, which happened to be my most popular video on my channel. So if you want to check that out, go check it out then. Now, this episode is going to have two topics and not just one, because the initial topic I was going to use for this video is 4 months old. So, naturally, I decided to fit another one in that was more recent. And I've also brought along some special guests to do some voices here and there. So, without further ado, let's begin.
The reason everyone is so disappointed of the Light Fury is we honestly expected better from DreamWorks in regards to How to Train Your Dragon. They have proven before that they are fully capable of making female dragons that make sense, like Meatlug and Stormfly, literally unable to tell the difference between them and male dragons. Why couldn't they do that with the Light Fury? Hashtag How to Train Your Dragon 3 spoilers.
How is that spoilers if the movie isn't even fucking out yet?
Do gay teen thrilly need gay movies? I don't know, does Toothless really need a white version of himself?
These dragons are gay and in love and there's nothing you can do about it!
I can tell you it isn't canon! Whoa!
You know, at this point I'm pretty sick and tired of the same old cliche love story and any mention of a potential love interest for a character I like. I'm like, God, please, no, please! I'm all about romance, but it never changes. I want to see more LGBT involvement in the media. Give all my favorite boys boyfriends and my girls girlfriends. It would make things infinitely better and better represented overall. Like for the new TTS announcement.
Whatever the fuck that means.
Either it's fine Toothless as a dragon, and people have a right to be annoyed that they are making unnecessary hetero dragon stuff.
What is this statement saying? I don't understand. I understand the second part. I think it's fine, Toothless as a drake. What does this mean?
Toothless will have a love interest in the next movie, so I'm left wondering what they'll do to make Abe's a girl dragon and not just any dragon so it stays hetero for the kids, lol.
Well, yeah, because Toothless is the last of his kind. Are you people really this retarded?
If I have to sit through a hetero dragon love subplot in the new How to Train Your Dragon, I am actually going to shit right there in the movie theater and hurl it at the screen!
It's Pride Month and you're giving us hetero dragons? Keep it. Ugh!
Quick, we don't have enough hetero agenda. Let's give the main dragon boy a girlfriend!
You trying to tell me Toothless is gonna have a love interest? He's a fucking dragon! Why can't a bitch watch a Disney movie that isn't about hetero mating?
Okay, first off,
please don't make the dragons hetero.
I'm bitter about the new How to Train Your Dragon movie because everyone is correct. That dragon looks terrible! Why did they change her palette so much? Why isn't she vicious and ugly like most of the dragons, or the same color as Toothless? Why do we need hetero dragons at competition?
You know what this series is missing? A hetero relationship for the dragon.
Alright, I'm beginning to be proven wrong because I love How to Train Your Dragon. But this romance with Toothless Lady Dragon is looking to be a textbook case of weird hetero structures imposed on non-humans.
Up until this point, Toothless was the last of his fucking kind, and your response to him being finally able to find a mate to create more Toothlesses, or Toothly, whatever, I don't give a shit, is, don't do that, make him gay. What the fuck is wrong with you people?
It's gonna revolve around hetero dragon romance, isn't it? And here my interest plummets. I love How to Train Your Dragon, but I have a bad taste of cliche in my mouth.
I mean, once this movie comes out, DreamWorks is pretty much gonna be rolling in dough by that point, so...
LGBT activism in the 60s and 70s.
We want to have the right to walk freely on the streets without being murdered just for being ourselves.
LGBT activism in 2018.
We want the dragon from How to Train Your Dragon to fuck a male dragon.
Why does heterosexuality have to ruin everything I love?
Who's ready for studio-mandated heterosexual dragons?
Please, please don't do this. Please don't force heterosexuality on dragons. They're dragons. It's Pride Month. Please don't do it.
Hey guys, the Light Fury is a lesbian. Sorry, I don't make the rules. I just enforce them. Using that new iteration of the WLW flag also.
If you were gay.
It seems Mr. Salzman was asked if Bert and Ernie are gay. It's fine that he feels they are. They're not, of course. But why that question? Does it really matter? Why they need to define people as only gay? There's much more to a human being than just straightness or gayness.
Why are they not? Not arguing, just wondering. He said he wrote from that point of view.
I created Bert. I know what and who he is.
You may have created him, but you don't seem to realize or appreciate what he meant to thousands of little boys growing up. You digging in your heels and wrongly conflating romantic orientation with sexual orientation with what seems like disgust is abjectly disappointing.
How odd you see my feelings as disgust.
If you aren't disgusted, why do you care so much about this? Come on, Frank, say it. I hate the gays. It's right there, man. Come on, say it. You know you want to.
What?
So, basically, Muppets possess every single human trait except the ability to love each other in a romantic way?
They don't have dicks.
I know it's unintentional, but this is transphobic. A person doesn't need a penis to be a man, let alone be a man who loves another man. Just want to point that out.
Let me check here.
Yeah, that makes enough sense.
Why the need to define people as gay? Because we exist? I'm gay, 100% gay. Always have been, always will be. I've known since I was 7, and was told what the word meant. Yes, there are a lot of bi and pan people out there, but there are also a lot of gay people.
But why accept being defined as only one aspect of oneself?
Please think why you haven't had to think about your own sexual orientation as something that needs to be validated.
I hate this. It couples with everyone's need to categorize instead of just letting be. If your music hard rock or metal, do you believe in God? Well, then you must be Christian or Catholic. You created them with none of this in mind, but it supports that agenda, so...
If you aren't gay, you couldn't possibly understand. Your straightness doesn't define you the same way my gayness does, because it was so repressed for so long, and it is a part of my identity, whether you like it or not. Now that gay people can be out and proud, it is a defining part.
Frank, I love ya, but I think this take is off. People like the idea of Bert and Ernie being gay, because that'd be a great way to add more representation to Sesame Street, and to help normalize gay relationships. If the creator is saying that's not who they are, don't be upset. Look for the representation somewhere else, where it truly exists. It's his creation.
With all due respect to Frank, an artist whose work I adore, I don't think the original creator gets the final say, or that characters can't be changed. If Sesame Street's current writers were to decide to make Bert and Ernie a canonically gay couple, I would be all for that.
The original creator doesn't get the final say of his creation. What?
Stuff changes and evolves. Look at Batman. So much of what we consider a core tribute of Batman's character flies in the face of the character as originally conceived by Bill Finger.
So, for example, Aragorn from the Lord of the Rings can be canonically changed into gay by a person other than Tolkien?
Sure, why not?
It matters because, of course, representation matters. The of course is what's really putting people off. It implies, of course, they're straight, because that's the normal definition of sexual orientation, which may or may not be what you intended.
I took the of course as meaning because they're Muppets. I think that every person takes from the characters what they will, and that's the purpose of them. They can be whatever the child wants them to be, which is why so many see so many different relationships between them.
Then straight, of course, would also be wrong. If the reasoning is because they're Muppets, then asexual should be the default, not straight.
The creator is speaking his opinion on what direction people are trying to take his creation, and the people clamoring for his creation to be what he didn't intend it to be are here trolling the man. Wow. Good job, America. Bravo.
More like the creator is being told by Sesame Street lawyers on what to say. He doesn't consciously think that they are gay, but subconsciously, they were created as gay representation, but he is being paid to tweet damage control.
I am so sorry that people are attacking you over something as irrelevant as this. They're just Muppets. Why do they need to be described as having anything other than a platonic friendship? I'm gay, and even I agree that the LGBT community is pushing the gay agenda too far.
Mrs. Piggy and Kermit are just puppets, and we don't go on about their respective relationship just being longtime friends.
Except those two have been confirmed to be an actual couple in 1978. It's not just viewers seeing a relationship where there is none, like with Bert and Ernie.
Actually, what keeps me awake at night is thinking about how the Cookie Monster was able to devour an entire truck. The answer is Vore.
It's for visibility of those similar to you, the viewer. I never saw anyone or anything gay as a kid, but I did see Bert and Ernie and just accepted whatever the relationship was. Fine, you don't want them to be gay, but don't act as though it's a bad thing, because it isn't.
I'm sure someone has already tweeted this to you, but no one asks. Why the need to define people as straight? You might ask why. You won't, of course, but you might. I think we're also seeing some of that classic separation of powers onset mentality. Performers, talent, celebrities versus writers. Class, in other words.
I'm imagining this fellow, the cinesexual, going down to his basement just to give a glare at his filthy VHS copy of Land Before Time, whispering to it,
"We'll fast forward all the way to the Great Valley,"
before shoving his 2-inch peener into the tape reel.
Maybe they just never felt safe enough with you to tell you.
Frank! Why the need to question the writer of these two characters? Queer kids need positive queer role models. This heteronormative society wants us to think they are the only people that exist. They don't love isn't linear. It's a spectrum. Thanks, MAGA!
D.O.P. parent. How do I explain Bert and Ernie being gay to my kids? Normal parent. How do I explain the president who raped his first wife, endorsed a child molester, said he'd date his daughter if he were her dad, and bragged about grabbing women by the pussy to my kids?
Obviously, the Sesame Street no homo statement about Bert and Ernie displays downright hostility towards LGBT people. But the more I think about it, isn't the whole point of Bert and Ernie to infantilize gay relationships? Of course kids shouldn't know about sex, but that constraint being leveraged by Sesame Street to portray an intimate, affectionate relationship between two men, type things, as chaste and childish is big thing.
I mean, it's not the most pressing issue of the day, but the fact that Sesame Street and Frank Oz went out of their way to respond to a gay Sesame Street writer who said he always imagined Bert and Ernie as a gay couple by clarifying that they're puppets and do not have a sexual orientation is more than a little hypocritical given the multiple obviously heterosexual parents in that universe. Like JFC, we've had decades of Miss Piggy / Kermit romantic drama, and we're not allowed to imagine two male roommates might like each other as more than friends. It's just the same old homophobic narrative that kids shouldn't be exposed to the same sex relationships because they're only about sex and nothing more.
I'm extremely disappointed, but not surprised. But also, fuck what they say. Let people see Muppets as gay. Let children see Muppets as gay. Let gay children, trans children, bi children see themselves in their favorite characters in their favorite kids shows. Yeah, we were all kids who watched it once, but there's kids watching it right now, and Sesame Street is trying to tell them no Muppets will ever be like them. And that sexuality is too adult a topic for them to think of, which can really affect
self development and self acceptance and education of LGBT topics. So who cares what they say? These characters belong to us as much as anyone at this point. Bert and Ernie can be gay if we want them to be. If it makes us happy, it's harmless, it's wholesome, it's good representation, and a writer of Bert and Ernie even said it's true from his point of view, and he wrote them as a couple for a long period of time. Bert and Ernie gay. Felix meows.
Since the stars aligned yesterday, I have a story. So when I was about 9 or 10, I went to my typically biannual dentist appointment. My dentist had an hour-long argument with his assistant over whether or not Bert and Ernie were gay. It started out with the usual, they live in the same apartment, they once slept in the same bed, etc., etc., and other controversial stuff regarding the LGBT that my late elementary school mind could only very vaguely know about. A lot of the discussion amounted to whether or not the gays should have rights over half a decade before 2015. I was oddly remembering this when I woke up this morning feeling discomfort over how homophobic that discussion was in hindsight. Except here's the kicker. I was supposed to have my dentist appointment today. It got cancelled. Bert and Ernie were confirmed gay. Hallelujah. Everybody clapped.
Okay, so what pisses me off about the whole Bert and Ernie thing isn't the fact that Sesame Workshop is not confirming that they're gay. If Oz doesn't see them as gay, then whatever, man. That's fine. I get it. What I don't get is the fact that they had to explicitly state that they weren't gay. And went as far as to say that they can't have a sexual orientation. Why not just leave it up to the interpretation of the Watcher? Just say that you can see it as you want. If you see him as gay, then great. If you don't, that's okay too. Would I love it if Bert and Ernie were explicitly gay? Of course! The representation would be very important to the LGBT community, and would fill with the years of writing that have based them off a gay couple. Obviously, that seems to be far from happening with what we've seen from Oz's and Sesame Workshop's tweets, but I just wish there was better communication between the creators and the viewers, where the interpretation was allowed instead of just straight-up denial, because now it looks like Sesame Workshop is favoring straight relationships like Kermit and his Piggy over gay relationships by saying that only straight characters get sexual orientations. In the end, I have no connection to the creators of Sesame Street or the writers who work there, but hopefully something can be worked out soon, because Bert and Ernie can't be kept in the closet forever. They just can't be.
To be honest, the whole Puppets Don't Have a Sexual Orientation thing that Sesame Street said to clarify that Bert and Ernie are apparently not gay doesn't make any sense because of the fact that a lot of Sesame Street Muppets clearly have parents, lol. Like, why can Muppets have heterosexual parents if sexual orientation doesn't exist for Puppets? Sesame Street, Bert and Ernie, gay.
The person who made the tweet about Bert and Ernie being gay in the face of Sesame Street is saying that aren't sexual is pan-ace arguing for them being gay. They are literally an LGBT person arguing for Bert and Ernie still being gay by finding a loophole in Sesame Street's bullshit logic to say that Bert and Ernie are definitely gay. So why am I seeing dozens of internet bandwagoning troglodytes declaring that this post made me aphobic? Block me, lol. Fuck these cishet aces. When it was a pan-ace person arguing that a gay couple is still gay in the face of homophobic producers, because exclusionists hate gay, bi, pan, trans aces too and don't bother caring if they're cishet or not.
To be honest, we knew for years, but Sesame Street was just cowards and wouldn't admit it. At least it happened in 2018. Never fucking ever say 2018 ever again.
Full offense, but the reason that Sesame Workshop is denying that the puppets have sexualities is because they're homophobic. Kermit the Frog is literally with Miss Piggy romantically, but oh no, oh whoa, they're puppets. They don't have sexualities. Like, Do y'all even see the bullshit you're spouting? This is another classic example of sweeping actual LGBT rep under the rug because they don't want to take 5 seconds to have to explain it to kids. And honestly, that shit hurts. As someone who has been told to the face that being gay is inappropriate for children, to even hear that fucking stings. To all the people denying that it's homophobia / are joking about it being Eros rep, literally shut the fuck up, lmao. What the Sesame Workshop did is denying children the chance to potentially see themselves in characters at a young age. Do you know how much that would have helped me? How much that would have helped other LGBT people? It's not just about the big puppets on a kid's show. It's about LGBT rep being erased and shut down because they think it's too hard or inappropriate to explain to children.
Yeah, bitch. We're gay. Keep scrolling. # I knew they were gay before I even knew what gay was.
LGBT. Let gay Bert and Ernie tie the knot.
No. Thank you.
If anyone was wondering why a bunch of adults who haven't watched Sesame Street since they were zygotes got upset over the Bert and Ernie thing, it's because LGBT characters don't belong in children's entertainment. It's a very small step away from, I wouldn't trust gay people with my kids, and we all know it.
Anyways, Bert and Ernie from Sesame Street are an old gay married couple and are homosexual. Pass it on.
Straight people. OMG, I love Kermit the Frog and Miss Piggy. They're so cute together. # soulmates. Also straight people. Bert and Ernie, gay? Puppets can't be gay? What? Throw self out window into oncoming traffic.
Deeply strange and bad to read a news ticker and see sandwiched between man injured in a 3-vehicle collision and a hospital on fire, Bert and Ernie are not gay, and while they may have human attributes, they are but puppets.
Straights. Tits are get the fuck out. Liberals. Gay puppets are get the fuck out. Seriously, what the fuck, guys? And yes, liberal is basically sexuality at this point. Yes, thank you.
I do something! Gay rights!
In full support of gay Bert and Ernie.
Remember when, like, one of the creators of Sesame Street was mad because people were saying Bert and Ernie are gay and he was saying they ain't because they're just Muppets? Well, now Bunsen and Beaker are gay. So we finally achieved gay Muppets.
Enrique Beto. Ernie Bert.
What the fuck am I looking at? Oh god, why?
If Bert and Ernie are gay, why do they have separate beds? First of all, so did a lot of actual couples for quite a long time in television. Second of all, have you met Ernie? Oh my god!
Approaches gay couple. Me. So, which one of you's the Bert and who's the Ernie?
Now listen, I never thought Bert and Ernie were gay, but with roommates being a big way to be low-key gay, it's a valid interpretation. Also, Frank Oz can fuck off with the, of course.
Insert 30 straight minutes of foaming at the mouth and autistic fits. We bring you back to your regularly scheduled tweet.
Fuck off!
Gays can talk shit about bisexuals all day, but at least none of us are reaching for validation in 2 old sock puppets that were made for toddlers.
Hi, I'll be auditioning for the role of Ernie, and I'll be singing If You Were Gay from Avenue Q.
Yankees say, Bert and Ernie gay! Rio!
Bert and Ernie from Sesame Street being confirmed as a gay couple in 2018? Best news this year, to be honest.
I fucking warned you, bitch!
Bert and Ernie are canonically gay, folks. Straights are now banned from Sesame Street.
Because representation matters, Frank.
Yes, it does. When it's honest representation. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe so that you can get updates on my latest videos. If you want to do that, then click the bell next to the subscribe button, though sometimes it doesn't work for some people. So if you want up-to-date posts on when they're coming out, be sure to follow me on Twitter or Gab or whatever I decide to post in the description. Also, huge thanks to all the voice actors involved with this project. Thank you so much. You are amazing. Links to their stuff will be in the description below. And that just about covers it. Love you so much, guys. Mwah. No homo. Oh, and if some of you are wondering why I have not created a Patreon, let's be honest, this channel is totally not ready for that yet.